BENNU is a near-Earth asteroid, about half a kilometer or a third of a mile in length. It has an extremely dark surface, made of carbon-rich material that probably dates back to the very beginning of our solar system. BENNU could contain the types of molecules that led to the formation of life on Earth. Because of BENNU's rare composition and its proximity in orbit to Earth, NASA chose it as the destination for its OSIRIS-REx sample return mission. In October 2020, OSIRIS-REx touched the surface of BENNU and collected more than 60 grams of material. This sample is now on its way back to Earth, and will parachute into the Utah desert on September 24th, 2023. BENNU will pass by Earth in 2060 at about twice the distance of the Moon, but in the latter part of the 22nd century, there is a tiny chance that BENNU could impact our planet. That's all the more reason to keep a close eye on BENNU. But for now, scientists are eagerly awaiting the samples to tell them more about the formation of the Earth, and maybe even the formation of life itself. Asteroid MATHILDE orbits the Sun in the main asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. It's a medium-sized asteroid, just over 50 kilometers or 30 miles wide. NASA's Near-Shoemaker mission visited MATHILDE in 1997 as the spacecraft flew by on its way to meet with its primary target, asteroid Eros. Although the flyby was brief, Near-Shoemaker learned a lot about the asteroid. When the spacecraft flew by, MATHILDE's gravity pulled it slightly off course. Scientists used this deflection to calculate the mass of the asteroid. Near-Shoemaker also captured more than 500 images of the asteroid, which scientists used to calculate MATHILDE's volume. Combining these two measurements to find MATHILDE's density, scientists learned that instead of being a single slab of rocky material, the asteroid is actually a loosely packed conglomeration of fragments. Astronomers began to call these kinds of asteroids rubble piles. Near-Shoemaker also saw that MATHILDE is pockmarked with huge impact basins, including one that is 20 kilometers or 12 miles long, which stretches halfway across the asteroid. The battered appearance of MATHILDE speaks to the fact that many, perhaps most, asteroids are not unaltered remnants from the early solar system. Instead, they've lived turbulent existences in which collisions are frequent, leaving these space rocks battered and scarred. Asteroid VESTA is the second largest body in the asteroid belt. Only asteroid Ceres is larger. Because VESTA is so big, it can sometimes be seen from Earth with the unaided eye, despite being very far away, orbiting the Sun between Mars and Jupiter. VESTA was the first asteroid to have its mass measured. In 1966, a much smaller asteroid called Arete passed fairly close to it. VESTA's gravity shifted Arete's orbit slightly, allowing astronomers to calculate the larger asteroid's mass. As it turned out, VESTA is very massive. It makes up an estimated 9% of the mass of the entire asteroid belt. In July 2011, the NASA mission Dawn settled into orbit around VESTA to begin a year-long series of investigations. Dawn learned that the asteroid contains a large metal core beneath the rocky exterior, making VESTA a kind of mini-planet. PSYCHE is a metallic asteroid that could tell us more about what lies at the center of planets. With an average diameter of 220 kilometers, or 130 miles, PSYCHE is large enough for its gravitational pull to affect the orbits of other nearby asteroids. Measuring these effects, astronomers discovered that it has a lot of mass for its size, suggesting that it consists mostly of metal. Metallic asteroids are rare and are thought to have once been part of the metallic core of a forming protoplanet. Instead of growing into maturity like the Earth or Mars, these young worlds are somehow stripped of their outer layers. If this formation scenario is true, PSYCHE could afford us a glimpse inside a planet, to the exposed metal heart that's usually locked away from view, buried beneath layer upon layer of rock. NASA is sending a mission of the same name to discover the truth about asteroid PSYCHE. Following a cruise of more than 3.5 years, the PSYCHE spacecraft will arrive at its namesake in 2026 to begin almost 2 years of scientific investigations. PSYCHE's cameras will show us close up what this rare planetary body looks like, including what craters look like on metallic bodies. PSYCHE's other instruments will tell us whether it is indeed the core of a protoplanet. Whatever we learn about asteroid PSYCHE, it's bound to be fascinating. The discovery of asteroid APOPHIS in December 2004 caused headlines around the world. Initial orbital calculations showed a 2.7% chance that the asteroid would hit Earth on April 13, 2029. At a diameter of 370 meters, or about 1,200 feet, an asteroid the size of APOPHIS is estimated to impact Earth about once every 80,000 years. An impact of this size would release 1,200 megatons of energy, which is far less than the dinosaur-killing Chicxulub impact, which released around 100 million megatons of energy. Still, that's enough to cause widespread destruction up to several hundreds of kilometers from the impact site. Astronomers rushed to provide more observations to get a better understanding of APOPHIS's orbit and refine its chances of impact. Thankfully, further data show that there is no danger of collision in 2029. Radar observations of APOPHIS during its flyby in March 2021 ruled out an impact for at least the next 100 years. APOPHIS's 2029 pass will come closer to Earth than any asteroid of its size in living memory. It will come as close as 30,600 kilometers, or 19,000 miles, above the Earth. That's closer than our geostationary satellites. During its cruise by our planet in 2029, APOPHIS will be visible from Europe, Africa, and Western Asia. It will look like a somewhat bright star with a magnitude of about 3.1, moving rapidly across the sky. While we can relax about an imminent impact, APOPHIS remains an asteroid that we should monitor closely, just in case it ever heads our way.